I take the opportunity of now inviting Mr. Krishna Yogi, the speaker for the day. Thank you, Krishna. I am introducing him briefly to you guys. He is a graduate in, postgraduate in financial engineering from the National University of Singapore, and he has done his engineering program from NIT Madras. Krishna gives me a hint that I must tell all of you, he's pretty much young to be a speaker here, but I don't know. The depth of his thoughts, I'm quite sure is going to take all of us to a state of happiness.
Yeah, of course.
And Krishna has been doing a bit of quant trading on his own, even without having sort of a background in technical analysis, and I and he bumped in at some point in time, and a sort of debate that usually arises around me happened again. So, typically the financial engineers world over have had a way to dismiss technical analysis because, it's mumboistic, jumboistic, it doesn't have so many nice, complicated, noodle-like formulae. Now, thing is, even with those formulae in mathematics, there's a lot of assumption involved. And the best ideas to trade in the markets are essentially from within the classical technical literature. So, I can't claim I've won the debate yet, it rages between him and me, but one outcome so far is that one financial engineer has started pursuing a CMT course now. So, that's less than a rare thing. And with this, I'll pass over the proceedings of the day to Krishna. Please tell us more about yourself and feel free to take players from the teacher.
First of all, before beginning, I have to thank. Is it audible? I have to thank every one of you for being here, especially ATMA and Mr. Sushil Kedia for giving me this wonderful opportunity. Before getting into the topic, I would like to explain you why we have come up with this topic. As you can see, summary would be, we are going to discuss the pair trading, which all of you must be knowing, taking new stocks and taking the spreads and all that, but looking at a different angle altogether. This is primarily looking from a statistical or quantitative angle with respect to the technical angle that you've been all looking at. And somewhere in the middle of the presentation, I will sort of draw a picture, similarity between the technical as well as quantitative, so that it's easier for you to appreciate the reason why we have this. Okay. Yeah. Okay. The topic is page trading, obviously. In its most basic version, as all you know, page trading essentially going long on one short and going short on another, and here and there I put some basic concepts, please bear with me if you feel they're too basic. It's just that sort of the flow is smooth to understand. And I would like to keep this more like an open discussion rather than me just presenting. So if you have anything, any idea popping out, things like that, please feel free to stop. I have a mic with me so I can pass on to you. So yeah, let's start off. Okay, the history is, in 1980s, this was when there were no computers driving the trading algorithms model. This was, before the crash of 87 or whatever. So Jerry Bumbusher had started up with the concept. The concept, even though was there in something like 60s, he was the one who actually pioneered the whole concept in Morgan Stanley. And obviously they made billions of dollars. So, and to go on to the flip side of it, you must have heard of long-term capital management, the infamous hedge fund, which blew off. Basically, they were also using a similar concept on the bonds, and when the Russians defaulted, they had to lose all the money and the government had to bail them out and all that. I'm just putting both of these in the same slide so that it's like there is an opportunity, at the same time you have to be cautious. That's my intention behind doing this. Yeah. Okay. So, briefly talking about in a big picture, there are three key components in the base training idea. The first being market neutrality. So you are essentially long on one stock or short on another asset. So you are covered with a directional exposure. There is no directional exposure. And of course, the central theme of the whole base trading is that the concept is mean reversion. So if you have, if you take two stocks which are absolutely correlated, and then you just cannot make any profit because they're absolutely correlated. Now, if you take stocks which are totally uncorrelated, then it's all chaotic. You have no idea what risk you're exposed to. So the idea is sort of try to identify the long-term mean and then see for any fluctuations in this long-term mean, and then try to capture the short-term fluctuations compared to long-term mean. So the concept being mean reversion. We'll get into this in depth later, but that is the core concept of base trading. Yeah, the final thing is the statistical and technical analysis, which we'll discuss later. Basically, what are the tools that we use and explore to identify these opportunities? Those are the concepts there. Okay. Before going to the market neutrality, has three concepts as you can see. The first thing being the exposure neutrality, as in you take the same amount of stock, market cap, the volume, dollar volume, and then you have to hedge them. You don't have to, it's not like options trading wherein you take a delta or something, it's just the plain hedge, the delta is one. So again, to cover up our risk, we are going to focus only on sector, a same sector. We're going to pick two stocks from the same sector so that the idea is to minimize the risk as much as possible. Okay. You must have all heard of beta, basically the correlation of any asset with the market. We're also looking at the beta neutrality. Basically the idea being we don't want too much difference in the beta so that the stocks blow off and end up in losses. So we are going to restrict the beta neutrality by 0.2. So if stock A has some beta, the stock two, the stock B has to be point plus or minus 0.2 from that. Okay, like I explained, mean reversion is essentially identifying the short-term fluctuations from the long-term mean and making a bet on that, making a bet that they are going to revert to the mean. Of course, as you all can think, you can actually say that, okay, after it hits the mean, it is anyway going to go diverge, right? You can also bet on that fact. But the point is that it's difficult. You don't know when to stop. So it's always better to stop at the mean. Okay. The statistical component is a concept called co-integration. We are going to discuss in depth, so please bear with me for a few moments. The other concept being the technical analysis, which you must be aware of, the relative weights concept. Like, we had a seminar in the last meeting, 80 in the meeting, where we discussed this in detail. So you can refer to that if you want.